Hi guys, I am Chanri Pakturanan and welcome to my YouTube channel. So this time, ang pag-uusapan natin for this lecture video is the example number 3 for the analysis of gravity dam. So sige, simulan na natin ang discussion. Hanapin ko lang muna yung slide na kung saan nandoon yung example 3. So ito na siya. Tadan! Then i-play na natin siya. So according dito sa example 3, a gravity dam as shown below, carries water 12 meter deep on its upstream side. The unit weight of water is 1,000 kilogram per cubic meter, while that of concrete is 2,400 kilogram per cubic meter. The coefficient of friction between the soil and the dam is 0.50. So, ano ba yung mga questions natin dito? Letter A, how far is the vertical resultant force from the hill? Letter B, what is the soil pressure in the hill? Letter C, what is the soil pressure in the toe? Letter D, what is the factor of safety against sliding? And letter E, what is the factor of safety against overturning? So, alin ba yung dam na tinutukoy ngayon dito? Ito siya, class. So, ito yung shape o cross-sectional section ng dam natin. And sa upstream side nga, may tubig daw na 12 meters yung kanyang height. So, sige, pwede na natin, class, simulan yung analysis nito doon sa ating OneNote. So, punta ako dito sa OneNote kasi mas madali ditong magsulat ng solution. So, I already paste the problem and actually, I already disintegrate the figure. So, ito class yung figure natin na i-consider. So, para mas madali, ang kinonsider ko dito, yung nasa baba, 2 meters kasi siya class, automatic ito na yung W1 ko. Okay? So, this rectangle, yan na yung W1. This triangle is W2. Itong rectangle ulit is W3. And take note, since ito yung ating width, di ba nga, ang definition natin ng mga weight, yung lahat ng bigat, mapa-concrete man or mapa tubig na nasa taas nitong width natin na 12 meters. So, kapag pre-project ko class ito, kailangan mong i-consider yung weight ng water dito as W4. I hope that is clear. Kasi itong W1, W2, and W3 para lang yun sa dam. Pero kailangan pa natin isama yung W4. So, sige. Pwede na natin class simulan yung analysis dito. So, ang unang step, by the way pala, meron pa tayong F1, which is hydrostatic force. Walang sinabi sa problem class regarding sa sa uplift pressure. So therefore, ang assumption palagi kapag walang sinabi, i-disregard natin or ine-neglect natin. So computein nga pala natin class itong P for future reference. So yung pressure natin is gamma H. So that is 9.81. Ang height ng tubig ay 12. Okay, so 9.81 times, ang gagamitin pala natin class, naka-specify pala sa problem na yung unit width is 1,000. Okay? Tapos sa concrete is 2,400. Marahil yung iba sa inyo magtatanong, sir, di ba density to? Hindi to unit width. Oo nga, alam ko. Kung magiging technical tayo, this must be a density, not a unit width. However, class, ang hydraulics, iba yun sa fluid mechanics, di ba? This is hydraulics. This is not fluid mechanics. So, sa hydraulics, katulad ni geotechnical engineering, halos wala nang pinagkaiba yung meaning ni unit width sa kani density. So, tinitreat na lang natin yan sa mga formulas as parehas lang. Okay? So, ang gagamitin natin for our solution must be the unit weight of water, 1,000 kilogram per cubic meter, while the unit weight of concrete is 2,400 kilogram per cubic meter. So, yun yung gagamitin ko. So, 1,000, multiplied ko siya class, ang height niya ay 12. So, this will be 12,000 kilogram per cubic upper square meter. Okay, so meron na tayong pressure. So, lahat ng weights natin and forces class, instead na naka-kilonewton siya, ngayon naka-kilogram. And that's okay. Wala namang problema dun class. Normal din sa hydraulics ng mga units natin ay hindi kilonewton. Minsan talaga class may kilogram. So, by the way, computein na natin yung mga weights. So, yung W1, madali lang naman yon. Unit weight ng concrete, multiply mo ng volume sub 1. So, ang unit weight ng concrete ay 2,400. Do not forget, nakalagay yan sa problem. And yung volume 1 na i-consider natin, class, is itong nakahigang rectangle sa baba, which is simply 12 times 2. Okay? So, meron na tayong W1. Pag kinompute mo siya, ang magiging sagot natin dito ay 2400 times 12 times 2. Ang sagot is 57,600 kilograms. Okay? So, 57,600 kilograms. On the other hand, yung W2 natin, class, ay equal sa unit weight ng concrete times volume 2. So, syempre, this is a triangle. So, yung unit weight ng concrete, walang problema. 2,400 pa rin to. So, since triangle siya, 1/2, ang magiging base niya ngayon, class, must be 6 meters and yung height niya ay 12 meters. Okay? So, lagay natin siya ng 6 times 12. So, of course, nakalimutan ko pala, formality, ilagay natin yung assumed na 1. Pero wala naman yan mababago sa computation natin, no? So, times 12 times yung assumed 1 meter na thickness. So, 2,400 times 1/2 ng 6 ng 12. Okay? So, ang sagot ay 86,400 kilogram. Yung W3 din natin, ganun din siya. Unit weight ng concrete times volume 3. So, 2,400 sa pagkakataong ito, rectangle, class, ang pinag-uusapan natin dito, 3 meter ito, at the same time, 12 meter ang height. Okay? So, 3 times 12 times assumed 1 meter thickness. Okay? So, 2,400 times 3 times 12 times 1. Ang sagot ay 86,400 kilogram. So, ayan, na-compute na natin yung W1 to W3. Ang last na i-consider natin ay W4, pero tandaan nyo, class, itong W4, hindi yan konkreto, pero tubig siya. Okay? Water ito, but still we consider this as part of the weight kasi nga, itong projection na to ay projected pa rin nga dito sa base niya. So, kasama yan sa analysis. So, sige, yung W4, since water nga siya, ang gagamitin mo dito, class, na unit weight, common sense, is the unit weight of water times volume 4. Ulitin ko, ang gagamitin natin dito for W4, since tubig ito, yung unit weight mismo ng water. So, this will be equal to 1,000 siya. Multiply lang natin. So, ang base niya dito ay 3 meters, pero kapag nagiging observant ka, alam mong ang height nitong triangle na to ay 10 meters. Paano ko, class, nasabing 10 meters? Kasi nga, diba, ang buong depth ng tubig natin ay 12 meters, diba? But since may 2 meter na dito, itong side na to ay 2 metro, so common sense, 12 minus 2 is 10, okay? So, that is 3 times 10 times assumed 1. So, pag kinompute natin, 1,000 times 3 times 10, ang sagot natin ay 3,000 kilograms. Ayan, na-compute na natin yung apat na weights. And lastly, yung F1 pala natin, kailangan natin yung F1, that is the area of the triangle, 1/2 ng 12,000, tapos 12. Tama ba? Kasi kung titingnan nyo, this is the pressure, 12,000 kilogram per cubic a square meter, tapos 12 meter ito, and ilagay ko na rin yung assumed 1, no? Kung mapapansin mo, palaging may 1 dyan, kasi nga kung babalikan natin yung introduction, palaging may assumed 1 meter thickness. Formality lang naman yan, class, pero hindi naman siya nagmamatter masyado sa solution. So, 1/2 ng 12,000 tapos 12, okay? So, ang sagot natin dito ay 72,000 kilogram. Okay? So, ayan na. Next, since meron na tayong mga forces, ang kailangan na natin i-identify, hanapin na natin yung writing moment saka yung overturning moment, diba? Yun naman talaga ang palaging next step. Solve for writing moment and overturning moment. So, kailangan muna natin, class, ma-identify kung aling mga forces ang i-consider natin as writing. So, diba nga, ang writing, pag ganito siya, ang moment niya counterclockwise from the toe kasi ito yung orientation, hindi tumumbling yung ating dam. So, ang mga counterclockwise moment na i-consider ay yung W1, yung W2, yung W3 and yung W4. Kapag magiging observant ka, mapapansin mong magiging writing moment sila, class. So yan yung i-consider natin. While itong F1 is an overturning moment. Okay? So sige, computein natin siya. So yung W1, ang centroid niya malamang kalahati ng 12 meter or 6 meter siya. So sige, sulat ko na lang yon as writing moment equals W1. Lagay ko as 1 half ng 12. Next na i-consider ko is yung W2. So yung W2 natin, class, nasaan siya? Nandito siya. So 6 meters ito. Kung i-consider natin from the toe, malamang 2 thirds ito ng 6 meters. Tama ba? Yes. This must be 2 thirds ng 6 meters. So lagay ko as 2 thirds ng 6. Next na i-consider ko is yung W3, and yung centroid ng W3, nandito siya, 6 meter na to from the toe, tapos kalahating 3 meters. Okay? So therefore, lagay natin siya 6 meter, tapos kalahating 3 meter. And lastly, yung sa tubig na W4, ang kanyang magiging moment arm, 9 meters ito, class, diba? 6 plus 3 is 9. Tapos, kalahati ulit ng 3 meters, which is 1.5 nga. So, W4, 9 plus 1 half ng 3. So, all you need to do is to substitute the different weights that you obtained earlier. So, yung W1 nga is 57,600. Okay? Sulat natin siya dito. 57,600. Ang 1 half ng 12 ay 6. Yung W2 naman, nandito na siya. That is 86,400. So, 86,400. Ang 2 thirds ng 6, class, ay 4. Diba? Yung W3 naman, na-compute na rin natin yon as 86,400. Ah, sorry. 86,400. And ang kanyang centroidal distance, 6 plus 1 half ng 3, this is 7.5. By the way, nakalimutan ko ng isang 0, 30,000 dapat ang W4. So, pakicorrect na rin lang naman. Plus 30,000, multiply natin ng 9 plus 1 half ng 3, this is 10.5. So, automatic, nakakilogram meter, class, ang ating writing moment. Okay? So, substitute natin, 57,600 multiplied by 6 plus 86, 400 times 4 plus another 86,400 times 7.5 plus 30,000 multiplied by 10.5. So, ang writing moment natin ay 1,654,200 kilogram meter. Okay? So, I hope that is clear. On the other hand, computein na rin natin, class, yung ating overturning moment, pero alam mong isa lang naman ang overturning moment natin dito, yung F1. Okay? So, ito siya. Kasi, di ba, kung titingnan nyo, ang moment niya magiging clockwise, so parang patatumblingin niya, class, yung ating dam with respect dito sa toe. So therefore, F1 lang siya times the moment arm na 1 third ng 12 meters. Sige, isulat natin yan equals F1 tapos 1 third ng 12. All we need to do is to substitute the values, class, that is 72,000, diba? 72,000, multiply natin siya ng 4. Kasi nga, di ba, ang 1 third ng 12 meter ay 4. So, 72,000 times 4. Ang sagot natin ay 288,000. 288,000 kilograms. Kilogram meter, sorry. So, ayan, na-compute na natin yung writing moment saka overturning moment. Ang next na isosolve natin dito, class, yung Rx at the same time, yung Ry, and lastly, yung x distance natin from the toe, diba? Okay, so therefore, balik tayo doon sa taas. Kapag drawing natin yon, malamang ang Ry usually upward din lang naman to. RY siya, at the same time, ito yung RX. Eh, isa lang naman class ang kokontrahin ng RX natin, yung F1 din lang naman. So, therefore, pwede na agad natin dito class sabihin na yung RX natin ay equal sa F1 or 12,000, 72,000 kilogram. Okay? 72,000 kilogram agad siya. So, next na i-consider natin is yung RY natin. Pero yung RY, marami-rami siyang sasaluhin. In fact, W1 to W4, lahat ng W sa kanya nakasalalay. Diba? So, lagay natin W1 plus W2 plus W3 plus W4. So, all we need to do is to substitute those values. 57,600 plus meron tayong 86,400, then another 86,400, then lastly 30,000. Okay? 86,400 86,400 plus 30,000. So, ang magiging sagot natin dito pag inad natin sila class, sige, 57,600 plus 86,400 plus 86,400 tapos 30,000 is 260,400 kilogram. Okay, 260,400 kilograms. Lastly, isolve na natin class yung x distance ng RY with respect sa ating toe. So, sige. Drawing natin siya ngayon. 12 meter class yung width natin. So, drawing ko lang muna. Ano lang naman to? Formality lang naman. Consider the width. Tapos, center line. Parang ang ginawa ko lang naman, kinat ko lang naman class itong dulong bahagi, no? And that is 12 meters. So, therefore, computein natin sa pagkakataong ito, yung ating RY. And, syempre, nandito yung ating toe. So, ito naman yung ating heel. And, di ba nga, this is overturning moment. Tapos, yung kalaban niya ay righting moment. Ang mas concern natin is yung distance niya na x. So, paulit-ulit din lang naman to. Yung formula din lang naman niya, class, is equal to x equals righting moment minus overturning moment all over RY. So, pag sinubstitute natin yun class, ang righting moment natin ay 1,654,200. So, lagay mo lang siya as 1,654,200. Yung overturning moment natin ay equal sa 288,000 lang naman siya. Diba? So, lagay mo siya as 288,000. And divided by ang RY natin is equal to 260,400, no? So, lagay natin siya as 260,400. So, yung x distance ay equal to 1,654,200 minus 288,000 divided by 260,400. Ang sagot ay 5.2465. Tama ba? 5.2465 na lang. So, mali pala class itong drawing ko. Kasi diba ang base natin ay 6 meters pa. So, therefore, nandito pa siya. Drawing muna natin. Ito yung RY natin. So, ayan. Kasi diba, 12 meters siya. So, therefore, okay lang yun. Hindi mo na nga kailangan ditong mag-drawing eh. Drawing ko lang siya para naman at least naiintindihan nyo na yung distance x from the toe. So, ayan na solve na natin class yung mga necessary. So, actually, pwede na natin sagutan class yung mga tanong dito. So, letter A, how far the vertical resultant force from the heel? So, this time class, medyo tricky itong tanong. So, yung iba, nadadalian sa dam to the point na akala nila ang sagot talaga sa letter A is 5.2465 meter. Alam mong mali yun class, diba? Kasi, ang tinatanong sa letter A, kailangan nyo siyang basahin ng maigi, how far is the vertical resultant force from the heel? Ang sinosolve natin palagi ay from the toe. So therefore, ang mas kailangan natin dito is itong y. Okay? So yun yung kailangan natin dyan. So therefore, para mahanap natin siya class, distance of ry from hill. Wag na nga tayong mag-imbento ng bagong variable instead of saying y, 12 minus y. Kasi nga, di ba, dig 6 meters ito dahil yung base naman talaga class ng ating dam ay 12 meters. Okay? So, dig 6 meters yan. So, therefore, hanapin mo lang class yung value ng 12 minus x. Sorry, bakit y ang sinulat ko? 12 minus x dito. 12 minus 5.2465. So, sige. Ang sagot ay 6.7535. 6.7535 meters. Ito talaga class ang sagot sa question letter A. So sagutan na natin class yung ibang questions. So from letter B and letter C, ang tanong is pressure at the heel and pressure at the toe. So therefore, proceed na tayo dito to solve for the soil pressure. Kung maalala nyo, ang palaging unang step naman talaga dito class is computing muna natin yung eccentricity, which has a formula of absolute value of x minus b over 2. Still, ang gagamitin pa rin natin dito class na value ng x is itong 5.2465 meters. Okay? So therefore, substitute lang natin siya, 5.2465 minus 12 meters to over 2. Kasi nga, di ba, ulitin ko, yung base sa baba ay 12 meters. Okay? So, therefore, ang magiging sagot natin dito ay equal sa 5.2465 minus 12 over 2, or pag in absolute value na lang naman natin to, 0.7535 meters. 7535 meters. And ang next step na lang natin dito, class, is i-check na lang natin, no? If ang eccentricity ay less than, equal, or greater than b over 6. Yun naman talaga ang process natin. Kaya 0.7535 ba ay less than, equal, or greater than, ang b nga natin ay 12 over 6. So, ang conclusion natin, 0.7535 is is less than 12 over 6, 2 meters. So, sa pagkakataong ito, ang gagamitin natin class ay case 1. Yun yung process ng pag-solve natin ng soil pressure. So, balikan natin itong PowerPoint regarding sa case 1 class. Ito siya. Diba? So, may formula tayo for Q min. At the same time, may formula din tayo for Q max. And instead of triangle, unlike sa case 2, trapezoid class ang mafo-form niya. Okay? So, therefore, lagay natin siya. Drawing muna ako, no? I-drawing muna natin yung mismong footing. 12 meters siya. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12. So, binibilang ko kasi siya. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay na? Tapos, nandito siya. So, ngayon, ang gagawin natin, lagay ko muna class yung center line. So, ito yung center line. Tapos, ito yung ry natin. So, computein muna natin class yung q min saka yung q max. Diba nga, ang formula ng q min natin is ry over b. 1 minus, ito siya 6e over b. So, pag sinubstitute nyo siya class, ang kalalabasan dyan ay equal sa, ano ba yung ry natin? Ang ry niya is 260,400. Sige, 260,400 divided by ang b ay 12 meters, di ba? So, multiplied by 1 minus 6 times ang e is yung na-compute nyong eccentricity, 0.7535. 0.7535 divided by 12. So, ang sagot natin dito, since kilogram class, ang unit natin, so 260,400 divided by 12, tapos 1 minus 6, 0.7535, 'di ba? Divided by 12, that is 13,524.525. 13,524.525 ang unit dito class ay kilogram per square meter. I hope that is clear. So ayan siya. Next, ang kailangan natin computing class is yung Qmax. Eh, ang formula lang naman ng Qmax natin, instead of negative, magiging positive, Ry over B, 1 plus 6E over B. So, all you need to do is to substitute 260,400 divided by 12, but magiging 1 plus 6, 0.7535 divided by 12. Okay? So, ang magiging sagot natin dito ay equal sa, palitan mo lang naman to class as positive, that is 29,875.475. So, 29,875.475 kilogram per square meters. So, magiging last problem na lang natin dito, class. Sino ba yung Q min at the same time, sino ba yung Q max? Pero alam mo naman na madali lang naman yun, class, malaman. So, kung ang Ry ay mas malapit sa tau, alam mong yung Q max ay nasa tau. Di ba nga, na-compute na natin, class, na yung distance niya from the tau is equal to 5.2465, unlike sa hill na 6.7535. So, technically, mas malapit siya sa tau kaysa sa hill. So, ang magiging itsura, class, ng diagram natin, although trapezoid siya, magiging ganito. Okay, so, yung Q min nasa hill, tapos yung Q max ay nasa tau. So, ganito lang ang magiging drawing niya. So, sa wakas, hindi na siya class triangle, kundi trapezoid na siya. So, therefore, pwede natin dito class i-conclude na yung Q hill is equal to yung Q minimum, and that is equal to 13,524.525 kilogram per square meter. On the other hand, yung nasa tau naman ay equal sa Q max. Then, that is 29,875.475 kilogram per square meters. So, ulitin ko lang ha, kung saan mas malapit yung Ry, doon yung Qmax. Okay? So, Qmax ito. And kung saan sa mas malayo, yun naman yung Qmin. So, nasolve na natin yung ating mga foundation pressure. Ang last na lang natin na i-consider is yung mga factors of safety. So, therefore, solve for the factors of safety tayo. Sulat ko muna siya. Dalawa lang naman, class, ang factors of safety natin. Yung una is the factor of safety against sliding. So, ang formula nun ay mu Ry over Rx. And yung pangalawa is the factor of safety against overturning, which is writing moment all over overturning moment. So, pag kinompute natin sila, class, so unahin ko muna, class, yung ating factor of safety against sliding. From the given class, the coefficient of friction is equal to 0.50. So, therefore, substitute natin siya dito as 0.50. Multiply natin ng Ry. Yung Ry natin ay 260,400 kilogram. Okay? So, 260,400. I-divide lang natin ng Rx. Ang Rx na na-compute natin, nandito siya, class, 72,000. So, makakanceled out lang naman yung mga units dito. So, 72,000 siya. Ang magiging final answer ay 0.5 times 260,400. Then, divide lang natin ng 72,000. Ang sagot ay 1.8083. So, napaka-safe niya, class, for the factor of safety against sliding. On the other hand, the factor of safety against overturning, ang writing moment natin is 1,654,200 kilogram meter. So, 1,654,200 200 divided by the overturning moment na 288,000. Okay? So, substitute lang natin siya, class. 288,000. So, ang magiging sagot natin dito ay substitute ko muna. That is equal to 5.7438. So, pwede na to. And since both factors of safety natin, class, are greater than 1, so ibig sabihin, ang dam natin is safe both by sliding and overturning. So, to finally end this lecture video, isulat na natin, class, yung summary natin. So, ano ba yung unang tanong? Letter A is the distance of RY from the hill. So, basahin ng maigi ah. Balikan natin yung question. So, what is the distance of the resultant from the hill? Ang sagot natin doon ay 6.7535 meters. Sulat natin, 6.7535 meters. Pangalawang tanong, what is the soil pressure at the hill? So, yung soil pressure natin doon is yung Q minimum na 13,524.525 kilogram per square meter. Sa letter C, ang tinatanong is the pressure at the toe. So, Q toe tayo, that is equal to the Q max, 29,875.475 kilogram per square meter, class. And for letter D, ang tanong is the factor of safety against sliding. So, tama. That is 1.8083. Lastly, for letter E is the factor of safety against overturning na 5.7438. So, tadaan! Tapos na tayo, class, for this problem. So, I hope may natutunan kayo, class, sa ating lecture video. So, i-end ko na to para ma-play nyo yung aking last example na prepare for the analysis of dam. So, this example number 4 is medyo challenging to, class, kasi meron ng tubig sa upstream side, meron pang tubig sa downstream side. And to make this challenging, may overflowing na nangyari dito. So, yun lang, class. Tapos na ako sa discussion. So, thank you so much for giving me an opportunity to teach you. So, yun lang. Bye-bye!